सर, अभी दूसरा क्वेश्चन ये है कि आपका समझो कि ये जो इसको एमईपी जनरली क्या होता है कि बिल्डिंग रेडी हो जाए, आरसीसी कंस्ट्रक्शन हो जाए, उसके बाद हमको ये एमईपी कंसल्टेंसी रखना चाहिए, या कभी से एमईपी कंसल्टेंट को हायर करके विल हैव टू टेक दैट सर्विसेज, एंड इज इट एक सवाल पार्ट ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन ये है आपका सर।
Now, as I have just mentioned about the first answer, you see the complexities of the elements in MEP design. Now, all these elements have to come right from the beginning of a project. When you start conceptualizing it, it has to come into the picture. Otherwise, the problem is that many times after the building is constructed or the design is gone on an advanced stage of this one, making changes to suit the MEP requirements will be extremely difficult. See, for example, I know in subsequently our subject is there specifically on the construction. My colleague Sarfraz will answer that a little more in detail. But generally, an MEP consultant should get involved with the designs right at the beginning when an architect conceptualizes the project. That is better for the project. That will save your rework, or otherwise, every time if there is a requirement, you may have to cut open, you have to demolish, rebuild. It can be avoided. Although, if the MEP consultant also is involved right at the beginning, like the structural consultant gets involved.
Okay.